Brother wants me to work on these sketches. Of the thousands of sketches we make, wonder how many finally see the easel. The repairs at home had been delayed for a while. It needed our attention and time. The machines of the press have finally arrived. They can make up to 800 prints an hour. In the last decade, our paintings have been widely recognized. Our patrons suggest a larger world awaiting our paintings. The press can perhaps take our paintings to that world. The first public show of our paintings in Bombay was a huge success. Govardhan Das, a cotton dynast, agreed to partner with us to start our press. The machines in the press run through the day with hardly any breaks. Saturday, 19 January, 1895. We reached Baroda early in the morning at 6:30. In the afternoon, we visited the public offices and the Lakshmi Vilas Palace, where one can spend hours in admiring the architecture, paintings, statues, and furniture. After a drive through the public gardens, we returned home. We never imagined that stones could play with colors. Every color has a different stone. Wish photographs could see color. Our models come to life only in color. Looking for them in Bombay too is difficult. Sometimes we just got lucky. Due to our uncle's death, we spent the next 2 years at home in Kilimanjaro. In our absence, the press was handled by Govardhan Das. But due to a disagreement between us, I started for Bombay in May. At VT, we were all examined for plague. Visited the press, no printing going on. Thursday, 9th June, 1898. The whole of the morning and afternoon spent at home. Visited Govardhan Das and settled the dispute that he should either accept our offer and leave the press to us or keep it to himself. He promised to give a reply on Saturday. Our portrait practice was widely appreciated. That got us invites to the Bombay theatres. Tuesday, 21st June, 1898. In the morning, went for a walk to chow party. In the afternoon, Mr. Sriram Pant and myself paid a visit to Anand Shivaji Desai's shop and selected a few of the German pictures most liked by the public. Our study of nudes helped us make some prints. But the censors were always on the lookout. On Saturday, we finally settled the dispute to keep the press. As the plague was rising, we borrowed some money and decided to shift to Ghatkopar. Our prints were so popular, we had competitors. But thanks to Mr. Schleitzer, our master printer, we survived. Only some of our portrait prints are selling. The one of Tilak has been received very well. He has been vocal about the handling of the plague by the British. Another painting commission took us away from Bombay. On our way back, we stopped at Kali and met Schleitzer. He feels we should shift the press from Bombay and avoid the plague. Friday, 20th January, 1899. In the morning, we visited Dr. Balchandra and Mr. Narayan Rao. In the afternoon, we visited our press and next went to the Tivoli Theatre to see an exhibition of the cinematograph. Saturday, 21st January, 1899. In the morning, we went to Fort to make certain purchases. We next went to Dr. Balchandra's house, where in a meeting, it was resolved to move the press to Kali. Many of our paintings have turned into prints. These prints have found new ventures. However, we still have issues. Saturday, 18th March, 1899. Schleitzer told us that A.K. Joshi was willing to purchase the whole stock of pictures printed, which would clear our debt. I don't think the arrangement is very good, but circumstances compel us to close with it. We made several sketches during our journeys. Sketches of everyday people. People we never saw later again. Tuesday, 8th January, 1901. The next morning, we visited Sir Balchandra and he advised us not to stay in Bombay as the plague is fast rising. We therefore tried to get our money back from Bottlewala and Company, but could not succeed. I spent a lot of time in Kali working on my landscapes. Brother joined me at times. It relieved us from the worries of the press. Sunday, 27 January 1901. In the afternoon, I commenced another sketch of the Visapur Hill and Fort. The nights are very cool and pleasant, but the heat in the daytime is great. We are negotiating with Schleitzer for the sale of the press. Monday, 9th November 1903. Today, we have severed all connections with our press, known as the Ravi Verma Fine Art Lithographic Press, selling it to Mr. Fritz Schleitzer. The proprietorship of the press was in my name, though it was called after brother. Our paintings moved on. To new times. And to new mediums. In the hands of the new artists, it found a new life. The press, perhaps, took our paintings to this new world.